Hello everyone. Today in this video lecture, we will go through adjectives, degrees of comparison. Before we go through degrees of comparison, let's understand in a short way what is adjective. So, in a short way, adjective is a word which describes noun or pronoun. It means adjective is a kind of describing word which always describes to a noun or pronoun. Let's see in the example, Sneha is a beautiful girl. Now, beautiful is here highlighted because it is describing to the word Sneha, and Sneha is here noun. Now, let's read these sentences. What does this mean to us? Riya is a tall girl. Riya is taller than Priya. Riya is the tallest of all girls. Now, tall, taller and tallest. These three words has been highlighted in these three sentences. But what does this mean to us? These three sentences, tall, taller, tallest. So let's know. In sentence 1, the word tall describes the girl. It does not compare Riya height to any other girl. It simply says that Riya is a tall girl. In sentence 2, the word taller compare the height of more than two girls, which is Riya and Priya. So Riya and Priya both are has been here compared. In sentence 3, the word tallest compare the height of more than two girls, means all the girls. That's why it is written Riya is the tallest of all girls. So one question is here, tall, taller, tallest, these all describing to the noun. But what these three different kind of word means to us? Tall is also adjective, taller is also adjective, tallest is also adjective, but these are used in these three sentences in a different way. So what does these three words mean to us? So it means to us that in some way, in another way, we can say that there are 3 degrees of comparison of adjective: positive, comparative and superlative. Positive degree, what is it? When we describe the quality of one person or a thing without comparing it, then we use positive degree. Remember, one person and without comparison means it will simply describe the quality of noun or pronoun. In example, we can see that Sneha is beautiful. Rohan is an honest person. Beautiful simply describing to the one person, which is a Sneha. Rohan is an honest person. Honest is simply describing to the one person, which is a Rohan. Now, one point is here to remember. We use as, dot, 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 as to compare two things or people that are equal in some way. Remember, that should be in equal. Then we will use as, dot, 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 as. Let's understand it through example. Sneha is as beautiful as Preeti. Now, Sneha and Preeti both are equally beautiful. That's why we have used as beautiful as. Rohan is as honest as Anil. Rohan and Anil both are equally honest. That's why we have used as honest as. Now, next we are having comparative degree. What is comparative degree? When we compare a particular quality of two persons or thing, then we use comparative degree of adjective. Remember this point. In positive degree, we only describe to one person or a thing. We does not compare. But in comparative degree, we compare a particular quality of two persons or thing. Means in comparative degree, we will always have a two persons or thing to compare. Okay. So here is some example. Let's see it. Tom is 2.5 meters tall. Sia is 1.2 meters tall. You can see. And Mr. Ravi is 45. Mr. Ajit is 50. Now these Tom and Sia both are having different heights. Then we can say that same things in another way. Tom is taller than Sia, of course. And Mr. Ravi is having different weight. Mr. Ajit is having more than Ravi weight. So we can say that Mr. Ajit is older than Mr. Ravi. Just try to catch this word. Taller than and older than. Now, point is here to remember that in comparative degree, we will always have two persons to compare, two things to compare. What is here main point to remember? We always use than me, than him, than her, and so on to compare. We use more before some adjective to form comparative degree. Remember this point. More is used before some adjective to form comparative degree. It is not compulsory that in every comparative degree we will use more. Here is written in some adjective. Okay, in comparative degree when we form, then we use more. Example, we can see that Richa is more beautiful than Neha. Now, more beautiful is here is comparative degree. And here Richa and Neha both has been compared. Two persons has been compared. Next, we are having superlative degree. Now, superlative degree, when we compare the quality of more than two persons or thing, then we use superlative degree of comparison. Now, try to remember positive and comparative degree at the same time, that in a positive degree, we only describe the one person. We does not compare. And in comparative degree, we compare two persons or a thing and then describe the quality. But in superlative degree, what is twist? Twist is here, we go beyond the two persons or thing. Here in superlative degree, we will always have more than two persons, more than two nouns or things. This is the key point. Now here is the picture, this one. See this picture, different size alphabets has been here. A has having different size, B is having different size, C is having different size. We can say that A is bigger than C, yes? A is not as big as B, yes? A is bigger than all the letters, of course. A is the biggest letter, yes? We can say that A is the biggest letter. B is the biggest letter, yes? A is not, A is the middle one. So B is, we can also say that B is the biggest in the group. Of course, we can say that in this picture, B is the biggest in the group, in size matter, okay? So the form biggest is the what? It is a superlative degree. The word biggest is used, that's come under superlative degree. So what we see that in superlative degree, we are comparing more than two persons or thing. In pictures, this A, B, C, we are having more than two alphabets. A, B, C, there are three alphabets. If we are having four alphabet, then we can also compare that. So in superlative degree, we will always have more than two persons. Beyond more than two, we will go. Point is here to remember, superlative degree will always often use with the. It means that whenever we will write superlative degree of adjective, before that we will always write the word or use the word the. For example, let's see in the example. Olivia is the best student in the class. Okay, Olivia has been compared in the whole class, not with the one student or two student. It has been written already. Student in the class, best student in the class. Okay, so best is here also used. Or best is what? Best is a superlative. Or before that, the has been used. Rule is saying that before superlative degree, we will use the. Next, we are having example. This is the most expensive hotel in the city. Now, the most expensive. Why not most? Because the rule is saying that we have used the word the before superlative degree. So, that's why it has been used, the most expensive. Okay. Now, without following any rules or regulation, we cannot make comparative or superlative of anything. Okay, so forming comparatives and superlative degrees, we have to follow some rules and regulations. So first rules, it says to us that for adjectives ending in e, we add only r and st. Just see the example. Large, word large is large. Rules is saying that ending in e, what is the last word of large is e. Okay, now rule is saying that we add only R and ST in comparative and superlative degree. Now see, large and comparative become the larger, only R has been added, and largest, only ST has been added, because rule, according to rule, we have to follow. So large is a positive, larger is comparative, and superlative become largest. Wise, wiser, wisest, same pattern follows. Brave, braver, bravest. Next rule says that for adjectives ending in one vowel plus one consonant, then what we do, we double the consonant before adding ER and EST. Remember, word is if given, see the example, HOT, hot. One vowel and one consonant should be there. Now O is a what here? O is a vowel. A, E, I, O, U, these are five vowels. So O is one vowel and consonant is here T, one consonant. Rule is what say? We double the consonant before adding ER and EST. Now T is a consonant, that will be doubled. Now see, in comparative, what it will become? Hotter, H-O-T-T-E-R. Hottest, H-O-T-T-E-S-T, hottest. Okay, so this way we will form superlative and comparative degree. Fat, F-A-T, A is a vowel and T is a consonant. Same pattern it will follow. Fatter, fattest. Sad, sadder, saddest. Okay, next point is here, next rule is here, for adjectives ending in one consonant plus Y. Remember, one consonant should be there and one plus Y should be there. Then what happened? Y will be changed into I before adding ER and EST. Remember, now see the example, we can understand it better in way. H-A-P-P-Y, happy is written. What rule is saying? One consonant should be there and Y should be there. Then Y will be changed into I. Now H-A-P-P-Y, P is what? Consonant. And then after Y has been used. Now Y will be converted into I. See in the comparative degree, happier, H-A-P-P, or Y, and Y has been removed and it will converted into I. So it has been used, happier, and superlative same way, I, happiest. Funny also will follow the same pattern, funny, funnier, funniest. Pretty, prettier, prettiest. Now next rule we are having, some adjectives like useful, beautiful, famous, careful, and some longer adjective take more in the comparative and most in the superlative. Remember, just see in the example, you can understand in a better way. Positive degree is important. Now how it is going to be formed? More important in comparative it will become, and most important in superlative. Okay, now the same way, useful, more useful, most useful, beautiful, more beautiful, most beautiful, famous, more famous, most famous, careful, more careful, most careful. So one point also is here, there are few irregular comparative and superlative, means there are some adjective which does not follow any rule, they are having their own rule. Okay, they does not follow, just we are having seeing that ER and EST, that way we will compare comparative and superlative degree we make. Here there are some adjective which does not having any regularity to form comparative and superlative degree. See the example, good. Comparative will be the good of better and superlative will become best. So it does not following any ER and EST or any IEST rule. No, they are having their own rule. Without any rule, they have to walk and they have to go through and they have to make their own comparative and superlative degree. In the same way, bad is also bad, worse, worst, much, more, most, little, less, least. So this was all about rules, all about degrees of comparison. What we see in degrees of comparison, we are having positive degree, comparative degree, and superlative degree. In simple way, we can conclude this, all this video series, that positive degree, what we do? Positive degree describe one person's or a thing without comparing. Whereas in comparative degree, we compare two persons or thing and then describe the quality. And in superlative degree, we go beyond the two persons or thing. We are having more than two persons or thing, then we describe the quality of that. So, and for making comparative degree and superlative degree, we are having different rules and regulations. We have to follow some rules. By following those rules, we can make perfect way comparative degree or superlative degree of any adjective. Without following, we cannot make any adjective comparative or superlative degree. And we also saw that there are some adjectives, very rarely, that they does not follow any rule. They are having their own irregularity, no any rule. They just walk on their own path. You can see in the last slide that it has been irregularity shown, that good, better, best, bad, worse, worst. So this was all about the degrees of comparison. Adjectives, if we are having, then adjectives have three levels or three degrees of comparison. And how we are going to make all comparative and superlative degree, and how we follow the rules and regulations. So this was all about the degrees of comparison. I hope you all might have understood. Thank you.